Storybook is an incredible tool that allows us to develop, test, and document all the components of our design system. And today we're going to walk through step by step and see exactly how we can implement Storybook in our Stencil projects. I'm really excited about this one, so let's jump right into it. So, Storybook is based on this idea of stories, which are essentially functions that are meant to represent our components in varying states. The way that works is we write these stories for our components in a specific story format, and then Storybook takes care of the rest and gives us all these ways to visualize and test and document our components. So today, we're going to learn exactly how to do this with Stencil components. All right, I'm starting with a brand new Stencil project here. So first things first, we need to initialize Storybook by running npx sb init, and then I'm also going to use the type flag to specify the project type as HTML. We need to specify our project type because Stencil generates web components, and we're going to use those components as custom HTML elements in our stories. Once the setup's complete, we can run Storybook with npm run Storybook. Once Storybook's up and running, you'll see that we already have some example stories set up for us. Now, these stories come from the stories folder that Storybook created for us when we ran the init command. We won't be making use of these in this tutorial, so I'm going to go ahead and delete this folder, but feel free to use these stories as a reference point, especially if you're new to Storybook. You may also notice that Storybook created a .storybook folder for us, and in here we've got a preview.js file. Now, this file essentially serves as a place to house any kind of global code that we may need to share across our stories. This is really important because it's where we're going to define our Stencil components, so Storybook knows they exist, and so we can make use of them. We can do that by first importing define custom elements from our loader, and then calling the function right below that. And this essentially registers all of our components so they can be used in our stories. Now, you'll notice that when we do this, we have an error here, and that's because the loader that we import from is generated at build time, and therefore doesn't exist yet. So I'm going to run stencil build to create that. And when the build finishes, you'll notice that the loader is now available. Okay, now we're finally all set up to start creating our stories. So I'm going to create a story for the my component component that we get when we create a new stencil project. It just takes in three props of first, middle, and last name, and then displays them in a greeting. So to create a story for this component, I'm going to create a file called mycomponent.stories.ts under the mycomponent folder. We could theoretically put this file just about anywhere in our project, but this is just how I like to organize things. As long as your stories files end in .stories.filetype, Storybook will pick it up. So the first thing I'll do in here is create my default export, and this is where we can specify all kinds of metadata for our stories, but for this example, I'm just going to specify the title. In doing it this way, I'm going to create a components directory and then under there a my component directory. Next, I want to create a template for our stories. And this is a common pattern that allows us to make multiple stories based on the same component in a pretty streamlined way. So what we'll do is create a function called template that takes in an args object and then just returns our component with those args as attribute values. With that in place, we can create our first story. Stories are created as named exports, so let's create a story called example and bind it to our template. Then we can just specify the arguments of our story, and we're all set. Taking a look at our Storybook now, we can see our title that we specified, we've got our component rendering properly, and Storybook also gives us these controls where we can change the values we pass to our component on the fly. And if we turn to the docs section, anyone who wants to use our component can see exactly how to do that here. Now, that's all well and good, but what happens when we make a change to our component? Let's say I change Hello World to Hello Storybook. If we look at our Storybook, you'll see that the change isn't reflected. And that's because our component is being defined by our loader, and that loader only gets updated at build time. So to propagate the change through to Storybook, we need to rebuild our Stencil project by running stencil build. Once we do that, the change propagates through to Storybook. But honestly, it's probably going to get pretty annoying to run a build every time we make a change. So instead, we can run stencil build with the watch flag, and this will now watch for any changes in our project and rebuild our project when they occur. Now we can make any change we want, and once we save, that change will be visible in Storybook. Now, this tutorial is really just meant to be an introduction on how we can integrate Storybook into our Stencil projects. There's so much that Storybook can do, so I really encourage you to check out the docs and play around with it. I will leave a link to the GitHub repo down in the description, as well as a link to a blog post that I've written detailing this entire process. As always, I really hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and I will see you in the next one.